that be breaking news for our viewers in the West? Every member of that soccer team trapped in the cave in Thailand, now free.
And take a look. This morning, those ambulances going by, all 12 boys and their coach have made it out alive.
Great news indeed. Their rescue, thanks to the brave crew working day and night to get them out. We're going to hear from one of those divers in just a moment. But first, ABC's Matt Gutman is right outside that cave in Thailand with the very latest. Good morning, Matt.
Hey, Michael. What jubilation here. You know, you never want to see boys taken out anywhere in an ambulance, but seeing those 13 ambulances come out gave everybody goosebumps here. Now, you can almost hear the collective sigh of relief here in Thailand. I want to give you a sense of what's happening. This camp is now emptying out after 18 days, and we heard cheers from the rescue crews and the military and even the cooks here, and even us in the media gave them a hand because this seemed so impossible. When those boys went missing in that cave, one day, 2 days, a week, 10 days, many people in the international press as well thought there was no chance that they could be found, much less rescued. Then they were found, miraculously, but then the challenge of getting them out of the cave. These boys were hungry, they had been sleep deprived, they had been in the dark for 10 days, they didn't know how to swim, much less scuba dive, and they were about to embark on one of the most complicated dives in the world. Yet somehow they were ushered out by those buddy teams in this miraculous rescue, and they did it ahead of schedule. Pretty incredible to watch. It's a miracle ending. All 12 soccer players and their coach rescued after a team of elite divers escorted them through this murky, dark labyrinth nearly 2 miles underground. All of them escorted to the hospital in a convoy of first ambulances and then helicopters. The 25-year-old coach who shared his rations with the boys, the last one to safety. Classmates of the boys jubilant this morning, holding signs, calling the rescuers our heroes. This student says he's very happy his friends have left the cave. The applause nationwide here, amplified by the speed of the previous day's rescues. The governor adding, today I expect it to be faster or at least the same amount of time if nothing unusual comes up and the conditions are good. We spoke with Ivan Karadzic, a diver with the international rescue team. He helped free the first 4 boys and told us about the difficulties guiding a team of inexperienced divers through this maze.
Well, the biggest obstacles is obviously dealing with kids that are not trained for neither diving and especially not cave diving. So that's the biggest thing. The actual cave, especially after they have pumped massive amounts of water on, it's not actually that difficult for a trained cave diver, but dealing with young kids who has been sitting inside a cave for 2 weeks, that is the challenge here, not the actual cave. It is the situation that is the challenge.
Overnight, swarms of rescuers, like the ones you see in this exclusive video shot a few days ago, replenishing air tanks by the hundreds, building stockpiles like this, walking that tightrope of water hoses slicked with mud. Those hoses pumping out millions of gallons of water to keep that third round of rescues on schedule. Monday's operation clocking in 2 hours faster than the first. Those 4 boys emerging from the cave in just 9 hours.
That appears to be the 7th right there behind us, the 7th ambulance.
Each boy to an ambulance, and each ambulance over the past 3 days signaling a small victory for this country and a boy's life saved. An incredible feat given the treacherous labyrinth rescuers were forced to navigate. In this video, you can see rescuers fighting to stay above water, gripping that guideline. Divers carefully weaving their way into the dark, dodging knife-sharp stalactites, pushing through powerful currents, and jackhammering through those tight passageways, all the while carrying oxygen tanks and equipment. These rope chains, their only lifeline out. It's a dangerous mission, even for the highly skilled. The cave claiming the life of a Thai Navy SEAL Thursday after he ran out of oxygen inside one of the chambers. 2 British divers stumbled upon them last Monday, huddled together even deeper into the cave than experts expected. One boy, named Adun, speaking English, asking how long they'd been trapped.
What day is it?
Monday.
Okay, but 1 week and Monday. You have been here 10 days. 10 days. You are very strong. Very strong.
Rescuers administering aid, wrapping them in thermal blankets, and preparing the boys both physically and mentally for the trek out to safety.
Now they're out, and I think that's the focus. You know, we have all 13 people out, and what I understand is that everyone is in good health, and I presume they're very, very happy to be reunited with their families and be outside of Cape instead of sitting in a dark little room.
Now, initially, local authorities said they might consider charging that coach because he had endangered those kids' lives. But now, after we all know that he kept them alive for 18 days, even sharing his rations with them, lots of people here in Thailand asking for a reprieve. Now, as for those boys, they're in a hospital right now. They're going to stay there for about 7 days. The first four boys, they're already eating solid food. Two have pneumonia, but that is easily treatable. They are in good shape. Health minister says they're in good spirits. They've even been able to see their parents through a glass partition. They're already asking for some of their favorite dishes. Their moms say they can't wait to cook it for them. But the moment I'm waiting for is when those parents get to give their children a hug after all these days. That's going to be incredible.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.